Some more confirmations came via a personal dream. On June 30th, in the morning, I woke up, and I wrote down this dream because it was one of the most beautiful dreams that I've had. And served as a huge confirmation about the rapture and the wedding of the bride. And note that actually June 30th was right before 4th of July. And this is when I was on a very high watch because of the fireworks dreams. You know, there were a lot of confirmations around that time. So I believe this was telling me to that, that we were kind of on the right track. But as I'll show later, it gave me a lot of additional information. So I was walking around observing what was going on. There were a lot of planned meetings. And I see Katy Perry hosting a group of people on a picnic on a field. So that kind of made me think 4th of July, right? On a picnic on a field. People were unaware and totally fell for her celebrity entertainment trick, whatever was going on. I knew that people were unaware somehow. And then I saw a very cute little boy, just a separate area, having an outdoor, very fancy lunch or a high tea type thing, outdoors in of a fancy Victorian house. And there was a nice table setting. Everybody was wearing like kind of older clothes. It felt like he was an actor as well. And the scene was a little bit creepy. The little boy was cute, but it was a bit creepy. It looked like an old photograph. It was all like kind of like in black and white. Like you would see where everyone's just staring and they're not really that happy. They just look very still because I guess back in the days, the photographs took a long time to process. So they had to stay very still. And they were all staring at me intently. So I kind of liken that to like an old money, a family with that's like old money, you know, because they were having some very fancy event outside. Then I saw a teenage girl that was being allowed to film a bunch of scenes in a street elsewhere. This was back to modern times. This is someone that I do know. Her name is Tahani, and that means congratulations in Arabic. So then I saw the girl, and I walked around in the streets with this girl. All of a sudden, I'm walking with this girl, Amanda, and she's a dancer. Okay, she's a very good dancer. And her name means, in Latin, she who is loved, and in Hebrew, gift from God. And I noticed that at that point it was very windy. And windy to me, this means the Holy Spirit possibly. And then I saw someone holding my hand. So all of a sudden I'm tucked away somewhere. And someone's holding my hand. And that my hand has a gold wedding band. And I knew that it was the Lord that was holding me. And I knew that it was my hand in front of me. But I kept thinking of a Jewish lady that I know. And this lady to me exemplifies Israel because she's from Israel. She is very into her Jewish community, you know, knows about all the feasts and stuff. So she represents like the Jewish, you know, lady to me. So I kept thinking about her, but I knew that it was my hand. So then the Lord was telling me, you will have the children of Israel. And I was hitting away from sight in a little hidden area of the streets, kind of like tucked away in a corner area. Then the scene changed to me drinking a fancy coffee with other students that I knew at a training room. And I see another of my dancer friends. Her name is Doris, and that means gift in Greek. And she was rolling her R's, and I thought it was very endearing. So, pretty cool. I'm kind of taken to the wedding by two dancers. You know, they're very good dancers. This lady, like, does ballet and, you know, very beautiful dancers. And both of their names mean gift. Dancing gifts, I don't know. And then, you know, it's like I'm Jewish or something because I've been thinking about this Jewish lady. And I'm going to have the children of Israel. So that was really beautiful, this whole scene with the dancers leading me to that wedding. But I didn't understand what in the world this meant with Katy Perry. So I Googled, you know, 4th of July Katy Perry, right? Because I was expecting if she was going to do a performance or something, if that was going to... And it actually led me to her fireworks song because it says, like, the 4th of July. So, but then I noticed that the scene itself of that video, it was not filmed in the U.S. It was filmed in Buda Castle in Budapest. So, which seemed odd to me for you to be saying, like, the 4th of July fireworks, but it's not in the U.S. So I'll play a little clip of that. So there you can see the fireworks, and that's Buda Castle. So I started to, here it is, you can see Buda Castle or the Royal Palace in Budapest, Hungary, with fireworks at night. And I had a look at when these fireworks occur, and it's St. Stephen's Day. And it's the foundation of the Hungarian state more than 1,000 years ago. New bread is blessed on this day, too. So I was like, oh, that's interesting. Did some more digging around about St. Stephen's Day, the day of new bread. He's the first king of Hungary, led the country into the Christian church and established the institutions of the kingdom and the church, celebrated with half-hour fireworks displays on the bank of the Danube in the evening. Here, if you look at what's going on, that looks like the rapture to me, you know? You see fireworks spurting out of all kinds of, and it's mostly kids. We know the enemy is very aware of timelines and prophecy, so it wouldn't be surprising to see it acted out on mainstream TV, right? Also of note, they say a lot, boom, boom, boom a lot, which is, you know, the sound of explosions, and even brighter than the moon, 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 so it's kind of bringing us our attention to, you know, moons as well here. So that was really interesting because this dream I did have when I was under high expectation of the rapture happening around 4th of July. The song says 4th of July, and then it's bringing me to fireworks at this place, which correspond with St. Stephen's Day, you know, just a day before the eclipse. So, which is still in the month of Cancer, and we are on high alert this month of Tammuz. Another thing that I found out, the names of the dancers are both, you know, gift, which was I thought was interesting, but also their birthdays. The first one, Amanda, her birthday is on March 12th. The second one, Doris, on March 13th. So I was like, okay, that's kind of interesting, you know, but I couldn't really, you know, think of anything relevant there. But today, I woke up this morning, and I received two confirmations. I had a dream just very early this morning, about the birthday of another friend of mine. Her name means love. That was just it. I was just being reminded something was happening with her birthday. And I looked it up, and there it is again, the March 13th, you know? And when I actually got up to look at my phone, because I had been woke up, it was 3:13 in the morning. So this has to be significant. And I always look up in Strong's, you know, the numbers that I get when I get woken up in the middle of the night. And it led me to Strong's Greek 3:13, born again. And I found a beautiful scripture, 1 Peter chapter 1. This is a commentary on that scripture. So during the beginning of the early church, there arose persecution against the church in Jerusalem. And as a result of that persecution, many of the Christians were scattered abroad throughout the world. And it is to these Christians who have been dispersed as the result of persecution, which is recorded in the book of Acts, that Peter is addressing here, primarily to the Jewish believers scattered because of the persecution in Jerusalem. But it also includes the Gentile believers, that's noted before, the elect according to the foreknowledge of God. So here we're talking about the doctrine of election, God having elected those who would be the heirs of salvation. And the election of God is based upon his foreknowledge. You do not read of election apart from the foreknowledge of God. Now, if you believe that God does know all things, and I do, you should have no problem with the doctrine of election. And Paul tells us in Ephesians 1 that we were chosen in him before the foundation of the world. Here, election is according to the foreknowledge of God. And Peter, in several places here in this scripture, does bring out this idea of called and elected and all and the foreknowledge of God involved with it. So here is the Greek 3:13, to be born again, and both of the only places where this occurs is in that scripture of, you know, talking about the elect. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. So, you know, that's telling us, being born again, incorruptible. That's telling me, you know, our glorified bodies. So that was really a beautiful scripture to see and to just get confirmation both on the birthday and on the time. So I did some more research on, you know, what's happening, what's so significant about March 13th that I might not know of. So, and I found the Ides of March, and that's traditionally known as March 15th, but if you look at the word, the Ides itself, it could be the 13th or the 15th. Typically, in the Roman calendars, is they didn't really number the day sequentially, and these were determined by the full moon. So I thought that was really interesting. I know the Ides of March are... It's when Julius Caesar was assassinated, and it was supposed to be a very unlucky time. And then I looked up the date itself, March 13, and look at this. It's the 72nd day of the year. And 72, I've gotten that scripture many times of when the Lord sent 72 pairs of two, and that is 144. So I think that might be pointing to the 144,000. And in my dream, the people that were born in this time frame, the two dancers, it was two of them. One was leading me to the wedding, and the other one was leading me, you know, to a training room. And both of their names represent gifts. So that was really cool. I was like, oh, maybe it's, you know, referring to the 144,000. There's, you know, pretty cool symbolism here. It could be related, I don't know. But that was when Pope Francis was elected. I know a lot of people think he's the false prophet. But there it is, March 13. I don't know if it was pointing me to that or if it's a coincidence. But also going back to the Ides of March, in the oldest Roman calendar, it was actually the first month of the year. Okay, March. And they were the Romans observed holidays from the first through the Ides, and the origin of these celebrations were New Year celebrations. So I was like, oh, maybe it's actually pointing me to the new year, okay? And if we take it, given that in this dream, I was Jewish, I kept thinking of this Jewish lady, I'm like, oh, maybe it's the Jewish New Year. And I know that's coming up very soon as well. After the month of Elul, we get Trishi, there's Rosh Hashanah. That's when the Revelation 12 signs occurs, right? The Jewish New Year. Is it this particular day? It could be. Or is it, if we're a month off, is it, you know, in October? At the beginning of the next month? Well, that's possible too. You know, I don't know. The Ides would have been not necessarily the first year, but the first, you know, until the full moon. So that could be here, the Feast of Tabernacles. That's around the full moon, right? This area. So, I mean, we obviously, I don't need to tell anybody that that is the high watch time as well, but I don't know. I mean, given that I did have the Katy Perry part of the dream, which was before that, and that's tying to August 20th when the fireworks occur in Buda Castle. And then that old money family was staring at me. I think it's possible something can happen here. Still, we're still in Cancer, right? Before we hit Leo. We saw the significance of Leo with the stone and all that. I don't know if the wedding is after the transformation. Maybe the transformation and then the wedding happens later. I don't know. So I hope you guys are staying encouraged. Like I said, I think that we're just about to start, you know, the high watch period that we had back when we thought we were in Tammuz 17, but I think Tammuz 17 starts tomorrow.